Welcome to part two of my series on FFT analyzers. If you haven't already, go check out part one. There's a link in the description. In the first part, I gave a very brief overview of the functions of an FFT analyzer: spectrum measurements, transfer functions, and impulse responses. In order to get into more detail about each of these functions, we'll take a closer look at the physical layout of the measurement systems involved. In the function overview video, there were two simplified system drawings. The first was a single channel system used for spectrum measurement. The other was a dual channel system used for transfer functions and impulse responses. Let's take a slightly more detailed look at the anatomy of these two systems. The diagram for the single channel system is actually fairly close to reality and doesn't need to be modified too much. First of all, the input doesn't have to come from a microphone. It can come from any signal source. That could be a mic, a mixing console, a signal generator, or the output of any piece of audio processing equipment, like an EQ, a delay unit, or a speaker processor. Here, the green lines represent various possible pickoff points that can be used as a measurement signal source in a simplified sound system. To keep the diagrams a little bit simpler, I'll just call any of these given options the measurement signal. The other change that needs to be made to the diagram has to do with the analyzer itself. It now shows the analog-to-digital converter that feeds the signal information into the analyzer. The dual-channel diagram is a bit different. It's helpful to think of the two signal sources as probes that attach to a sound system at various points. The ability to place our two probes wherever we want is what makes our analyzer such a useful tool. Let's look at a simple sound system. We have a singer singing into a mic, which is fed into a digital mixer, and from there into an equalizer, into a crossover, into a speaker consisting of two different drivers, a tweeter and a woofer, which then propagates into a venue. With a single channel measurement, we could take our measurement signal from anywhere in the sound system, and the analyzer would tell us absolute information about the signal at that point as it passes through the sound system. So if we measure the signal coming out of the digital mixer, we'll get information about the singer, the microphone they're singing into, and the digital mixer. But if we only wanted to know about the digital mixer itself, this information isn't actually helpful to us, because we're getting excess information about the singer and the microphone, which are two unknowns. With a dual channel system, we can take our measurement signal from the mixer output and our reference signal from the mixer input. When the analyzer performs a transfer function, it tells us information about how the signal changes as it passes between our two probes. Everything between the probes can be called the system under test, and this concept is sometimes called source-independent measurement. I'll explain this in further detail in a later video focusing specifically on transfer functions. For reasons that I'll discuss in that video, we often use something called pink noise as our signal when performing transfer functions. Pink noise sounds like this. We use a pink noise generator to do this, in which case the system might look something like this. Again, more on that in that later transfer function video. When doing general system tuning work, the measurement system often looks like this. Here, the system under test is the speaker processing, the speaker, the venue, and the measurement microphone. With any luck, this video has answered some questions and created others. Please let me know in the comments here if you have any questions or would like me to clarify something from this video. Thank you for watching. If you want to learn more about FFT analyzers, don't forget to click that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video.